execution strike together with the revenge strike. I guess he should be able to go for it, but does get stunned up. He needs to be careful. Kilowash is there. He's still only level 1, though, but so showing a lot of confidence on this hero.
Yeah, because right now, Esmeralda really can't walk up. She's pretty low. If a full rotation of the execution strike hits, she's done for.
Oh, wow. Here comes Evos onto the bottom Hermit Crab. The top one did go to Archangel, so I guess that sort of equals it things out.
Yeah, looks like Solo's going to try and get a catch on to Kilowash.
Kilowash, but there's a stun. Goes one more. Will it be another dunk? To the first blood. Soul says, hello, sir. Have a good day.
Really nicely done by Soul using that brush tactics to ensure to get that kill, especially considering that Kilowash wanted to get the buff.
Bambi sword spike lands, but doesn't want to take it. He was a little bit afraid, thinking that he doesn't have enough damage to actually kill off that Archai.
Not to mention, it's a little deep considering that Kilowash is respawning, though he is level 4. If he uses all of his abilities, he can't just go head-to-head against anybody.
Alright, so this is a little bit disrespectful already, because they can see four members are coming through. Good magic dump. Lance, Violet Requiem is there. Ace is super low. Need to be careful here. Battle Diesel does stand in the backline, but it's not enough. Bambi needs to be careful. He actually takes back the Soul Spot. That's a big, big mistake. They need to wrap up, but here comes the rest of Evos. Flicker Impulsion. Lance on the 2. Can they finish off anyone? They take the Lolita. Can they kill off Kilowash? Kilowash has so much shield. Auto attack. One more hit. Can they take it? They take the Esmeralda. Rio jumps back in the magic dunk. The hammer with the knockout. Rio finally reckon once again. The passive is there. They have to back off. Meanwhile, on the top side, though, you can see small energy wave just missing there. That was a close fight.
JPL manages to get out of there. Somehow Soul, he goes in with a full combination, walks out with just a sliver of his HP. Evos make it out with a slightly better trade. However, this game is getting bloody real fast.
The one thing we need to highlight is that this Claude has been farming all the way. When that skirmish was happening, they were just farming. That's why now Jeff Kitty Forever, he's going to be ahead of the curve.
Oh yeah, and now Soul, he's going to take the damage. He doesn't mind. He's going to heal up and all from that wave. However, he's purposely disrespecting
Jay. The bait off the board. I do not believe this. What? But the Soul Spike there doesn't hit. Ace now gets tanked up. There goes the magic thumb. There goes the Violet Requiem. There goes the kill. This is going to be two. Soul needs to back out. He does have to sprint, but can he run away fast enough? I do not think so. One more hit. There goes the kill. Archangel walk away 2-0.
Oh my goodness. Unfortunately, Oh Dear Bambi wasn't able to pick up that kill onto Jay, but they still make it out, losing two members in the process. Archangel take control over Turtle.
Let's slow things down. The Turtle did go over. However, Potato got that bottom turret. Jeff Cutie Forever going to equalize the turret count, taking the top one.
Yep, down on bot side. Evos is trying to take control wherever they can, trying to, you know, make up for the lost EXP that Archangel has used to catch up.
Yeah, so far though, once again, Bambi's Gusher not really impressive. Same goes to Ace's Kaja.
They haven't found the pick or the fight just yet. It could be the stamina. Not too sure. They've been playing all day long.
But same goes to Archangel. They played a game in the morning against Lure Esports.
Yeah.
So, you know, stamina, you can't really blame that anymore.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Oh Dear Bambi doesn't want to commit to this just yet. Doesn't see the benefit of going in.
Did force out a flicker. So that's at least one battle spelled out.
Yep, still pretty worth it in my books. Let's see. I want to see how Soul is doing up in that top side, because right now he's going to continue with his oppression, but can he make a difference in these bigger team fights?
But you know, you mentioned over and over again, Esmeralda counters Turitzla. Whenever, you know, you go for these long drawn out fights, that this Esmeralda just constantly going to pop that Frostmourne shoe, constantly Stardust dance you. You cannot burn her out.
Yeah, but I mean, she has caught up in Soul. This is exactly what I mean. Soul really can't do too much. He has to back away.
Oh no! He does have the execution strike, but I don't think he has enough damage. That's three members coming through. Oh, he has to run. He does have to sprint. There goes the slow onto the revenge strike. He's trying to run left, right, and center. He's just trying to clear the wave. He wants to buy time. Evos taking the bottom turret. But look at the minion. Jeff Cutie Forever going to take that mid tier two.
They're going to rotate. Hopefully they can pick up Jeff Cutie Forever here. He tries to join up with the rest of his team. They're going for the big regroup. Doesn't take that tier 2, but they will cut the waves.
Well, Archangel coming to this top side. They have four members. Potato is not there as well. Looks like Evos can defend this. They want to go for Turtle instead.
Yeah, so far JPL hasn't found, like, you know, that big implosion play with the flicker just yet. But again, This is where it all comes down to.
Oh,
who's
no.
Who's going to get Turtle?
Evos needs to be careful. JPL with the face check. The stun is that. Oh, Jay, that's a mistake here. He does get pushed back by JPL. He does have the Hurricane. That's Turtle down to around 50% health. This is going to be a 4-on-5v5, Gideon.
Yep, and I think they need to kind of go in now. Jay is probably going to buy some time with a Hurricane Dance, but I think they can actually win this.
They're not going to contest. Looks like Evos was happy to just let it go and be frozen for a little bit.
Looks like even... again, a stalemate, but in favor of Archangel. They catch back right up and slowly are building a lead, but so far it's about 50-50.
Yeah, I can see the goal lead is basically nothing, right? Like, it's only 400 or 500. It's something, but it's not really worth a shout.
Yeah, this is going to be a tough game coming in for both of these teams. They're showing a lot of respect.
Yeah.
I think that's number one here.
But remember, Potato on this carry, the late game we've seen time and time again, is going to be very, very effective, the stun. Lands onto the carry, just going to force him back off.
Yeah, Killwash is also scaling pretty well into this game. He's going to be a force to reckon with, especially if Potato. He's got to be super careful because Killwash, if he runs through the team and generates enough of a shield, I don't think that he'll be able to cut through it, even with true damage.
Yeah, I think so too. They need to be careful on this Esmeralda. Falling Star Moon can engage through it very, very deep. But Evos, they're playing a little bit too passive at the moment, I feel.
Considering...
Turret Slaw in the flank. Could this be go?
I don't think they know.
Oh no, they know. Mistake comes true, but no fall. Jay with the flicker out to it. JPL comes true. Sacred Hammer on Turret Slaw into the backline, but the stun is there. Makes it to it. Falling Star Moon just immediately wrecks out the gusher. Carry still staying alive though. Look at the backline. Turret Slaw just doing the work. So doing what he can, but it's not going to be enough. It's a 3-for-2 exchange here.
Oh, 3-for-2, unfortunately, in favor of Archangel. Killwash just holding back Evos's back line here.
You could see, though, that was a big, big mistake from Ace.
Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately enough, it happens. You got to keep moving forward. However, the fight hasn't stopped.
So, needs to be careful. He's actually turning things around. This is insane. He has the Bloodlust Axe. He has lost Spellbam. That just forced everyone to retreat and recall.
It absolutely helps when you have Spellbam. Especially when there is a minion wave on top of them. Look at that. Wow. From what looks to be like an okay game, it turns back into their favor. Now Archangel in the lead with at least a 1.4k goal lead.
Two very equal teams. That's what the graph says. It's basically tug of war.
Now, here's the big kicker. Whoever gets Lord is going to be in control of the game.
It's all about that one big team fight.
Can they get the Lord?
Oh, it's really hard. I mean, like I said, man, Gusion, Kaja, not really performing this game. On the other hand, Archangel, they are quite on point. But once again, the goalie is not that big of a deal.
I mean, not to mention that a lot of these ultimates are very zone-based. They control a large amount of area. That Numenon Blast is a huge, huge spell.
But Jeff Cutie Forever just finished his golden staff. He's going to hit like a truck here. Ace gets called out. I don't think he's going to be able to walk away from this. Once again, a really good pick onto the Kaja.
Yep, but they are going for that split. You can see Turitzla on the other side trying to protect that tier 2.
Oh, I don't think it's going to be in time. Meanwhile, Potato does take that tier 2 on the side. Good damage onto Soul. Jeff Cutie Forever does have the battle royale image. Stun does come true. So, protecting that turret. Good job there. And you can see Archangel though still within that small little lead.
Yeah, and you can see Evos, they know the priority is Overlord. Archangel using that against them, playing across the map to force Evos to pull themselves apart. If they get on top of Lord right now, Archangel can respond.
Oh, Potato. Actually, have you noticed? Potato has Weakness Finder.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's a little different.
So what Weakness Finder does, since not a lot of people pick it, let me explain it really quickly. Every single auto attack has a chance to slow down the enemy for 90% across 1 second.
90%?
So, 90%. So basically, a really bad slow.
Oh yeah. I mean, it's a crippling slow. It's like 10% off from being a stun.
Yeah, so it's going to be quite interesting to see. So far, it hasn't really shown up yet.
Yeah.
But let's see, you know, maybe a team fight where they can just run it down.
I mean, a lot of teams usually go for that Bounty Hunter. They know they can, you know, especially in a competitive sense, they can get those assists, ensure that they get that extra gold every single time they have an encounter with the enemy.
Yeah, you need to kill with the Bounty Hunter to get the extra gold.
Oh, yeah. That's true. But, I mean, with a team, especially in a competitive sense, they're able to hand these kills over to...
And JPL finds Killwash, but remember, they're doing onto Lord. That's the main target. They want to finish this off. Lord, down to 40% health. Ace needs to back up. Magic Thumb doesn't land on. No! Divine Judgment has been waiting on the side of Ace. This is a big, big spell. They want to go for it. Where's the knockout penalty? So, lands on the Jeff Kitty Forever. Can they kill her? Implosion as well. They're just exploding everyone. Lord goes over to enjoy it now. They're just ripping this fight apart. They're just killing everyone inside of Evos. Still surviving. Can they go for it? No! Soul will fall as well. It's a 3-for-2 exchange by EVOS losing Lord.
Oh my goodness. Lord goes into the hands of Archangel. Archangel with just a sliver. One more auto attack off from actually making this so huge for them. It could have been a 2-for-4 trade.
Yeah, it was close. It was close. But Archangel is firmly in the driver's seat.
Yep, they're going to be taking every single tier 2 here. The real question is whether or not EVOS Esports SD can protect their inhibitor tyrants. They cannot afford to let that fall.
They need to make sure that all the inhibitors are out, because if not, it will be really tough for them to come true because of those super minions.
Lord empowered minions are so frustrating to deal with, especially since it's so early into the game. However, EVOS has scaled nicely. 3 level 11s plus.
Oh, they are just setting a bait on this bottom side turret. But yeah, Archangel, I don't think they're going to find anything. EVOS just going to let that fall. They do not want to risk this.
I don't think they want to stick their nose out too far. They got to be careful. Yeah, they're willing to let this go. It's not worth sticking your nose out too far and getting caught off by someone like Jay.
Oh, they say launch the attack. They want to try and rush this maybe, but so in the front lines. Wow. Execution strike, basically just executing a Lord.
Oh yeah, Golden Staff just being bought by that carry. That's going to be a huge buy.
I think that's the third item on the side of carry. I think the carry is now fully online. The real question is whether she can stay alive long enough.
She's got to be super careful. There's a lot of things she has to dodge, and I think that Numenon Blast is the biggest spell that, because it just tells her you don't get to auto attack in this particular area.
Yeah, and remember what we discussed during the drop, Archangel, they have a lot of gap closes into the back line.
Yep, and again, it's going to be tough, but we're just going to have to see if Archangel can find that angle here. And so far, Jeff Cutie Forever, he's been finding these huge, completely massive blazing duets.
Feather of Heaven done on the side of Kilowash. Same goes to Ryo on that Divine Glaive. Going to hit like a truck now. Can see carry is pretty farmed up, but the rest of EVOS isn't.
Oh boy. 5k goalie ain't looking too good for Archangel. A lot of their members are getting their third to even fourth item at this point. And now EVOS slowly trying to catch up here, but it's looking a little grim.
Now let's see what can they do. They're being very, very slow here, making sure they don't make any silly mistakes here. Archangel can see they're all hovering around the base of EVOS. Now, it can kind of backfire because, one, yeah, you're controlling a lot, you're taking the enemy jungle, but you're giving them a safe space to farm.
Now, I think for Archangel, their next power spike is probably coming around 41k. That's when they're going to get their final items for their carries, and I think that's going to make enough of a difference to end this game on Lord. So, another 60 more seconds or so until Lord spawns. EVOS, on the other hand, they're just trying to catch up in terms of gold so that they can kind of stop the bleeding.
Yeah, I can see now the gold deficit has sort of evened out at 6k or so, so that's not the main issue there. The main problem is going to be the next Lord fight.
Yeah. So again, if I was Archangel, I'd probably want to farm up, deny resources off of EVOS Esports, then look to force a fight onto Lord when you have that item power spike.
No, they are indeed denying every single thing. You can see the whole jungle is all towards them. Oh, Kilowash went for the Falling Star Moon on the side of JPL, but they're just going to back up for now.
Yeah, they got to be super, super careful. They don't want to make any mistakes because every game counts here. They want to have the momentum coming into game 2 and also with the backing of their fans.
Yeah, I can see the whole crowd. Whoa, we're finally in a full crowd now. Everyone is stuck in their seats because Archangel is looking good in this game 1.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough game. It's coming over very close until Archangel is going to hit their final items here. Full build coming very soon.
EVOS making it slow. Blender does get tagged on the side of JPL. The Lord is going to spawn within 3 seconds. Now, Potato just bought Wind of Nature. Should be able to withstand the Blazing Duet in the next team fight, but is it going to be enough?
It's going to be real scary because he's got to time it nicely. If not, he's going to get chunked out before it's even going to protect him. So here it comes, Archangel onto Lord already. It's going to force a fight here.
Down to 50%. Remember, they do it so, so quickly because of the Claw. Turitzla on the backside. There goes the Magic Dump onto Maruka. But they're just calling on to JPL. That's not really the one that they want. There goes the Divine into it. Oh, they're trying to run away. Ace super low. Bambi super low. Here comes the Potato onto the target. Everyone's just falling. They cannot fight. Energy Wave doesn't land, but it doesn't really matter. So still staying alive, but they doesn't care because they're just going to lose every single one of EVOS. They do kill off Jeff Cutie Forever, but Soul is going to fall as well. It's going to be a 4-for-1 exchange.
Archangel take out 4 members of EVOS Esports. They want to end this game. The death timers are a little too long, but I think Tigreal might be able to buy a little bit more time.
Oh, I think that turret is a little bit mobile because the minions getting focused out. Good Divine Judgment onto an Ace, finally clearing up that last minion. Magic Thumb doesn't land. Energy Wave gonna kill him off. And EVOS, they are backs against the wall time.
Now, Archangel, they're gonna go for one last push after they get a little help from Lord to help secure this game.
Yep.
And end EVOS.
I don't think EVOS has any way to come back from this unless they get a miracle steal. With, you know what? It's not too far-fetched because you can see Gushen making their way through, and oh, they're gonna initiate a retreat instead.
Huh. Looks like they didn't want Esmeralda to come help them out with this. But no, they're sticking around a little too long. This doesn't look too good for an Archangel here.
Yep.
EVOS could turn this around potentially.
They're not resetting. They're not resetting. Okay, they finally go for it. Magic Dump onto two, but Potato's outside. Rio is super low. They're going for Rio. Winter Charger is there. Jay into the backside. Numenon Blast catches on the Gushen, and there goes the Potato. Rio still staying alive. Implosion into everyone. But Jeff getting forever. He's just doing so much damage. Here comes Potato getting focused out. He gets stunned up. Ace is there. They do kill Archon, but Potato's down. Jeff Kitty forever is still auto-attacking Sacred Hammer to knock him out. Not gonna be enough. Hey, they feel this. They want to end game one. They have only sold the fall, but they don't care about it, Larissa. They only want to end the game.
Oh my goodness, and this is going to be game four. Archangel gonna lock this one out. Soul goes down. That's the last member from the side of EVOS Esports SG as Archangel look to close out this game in the next wave.
They say, you know what? It doesn't matter if you don't have minions. Oh, wait. Hello?
Okay, wait a minute.
Hello?
Okay, wait.
Hello?
Okay, wait a minute.
All right, all right. There it is. Game one over to Archangels.
Oh my goodness, now with the lights, I can see everybody. There are so many people supporting Archangel here.
It's crazy amount of support, but remember, it is a best of three. However, you can't deny Archangel doing really, really well.
Yeah, Archangel doing an amazing job trying to put EVOS back into their place, especially locking out that carry from that game.
Yeah, I think, look at the endgame stats. What do you think here, Gideon?
I mean, honestly, Potato was kind of struggling with the rest of his team. They're going in hard. However, you have to remember that Jeff Cutie Forever still can chunk him out.
Yep.
He has a lot of damage.
But Kilowash on his Esmeralda.
Oh. Woo! That is just nasty. Like, what can you do? What counterplay do you have?